Yes, my ramblings about Georgia. I'm going to talk about sturgeons here, and yes, this is my sturgeon hat. I jumped across the border from Armenia into what you'd imagine the quite unassuming Georgia, but it's got one of 14 writing scripts in the world. It's the oldest wine producing region. It's got Bassiani, one of the best clubs in Europe. It's got two of the world's biodiversity hotspots. It's got a birding ground home to over 1 million species a year, and Batumi, one of the leading tourist destinations. But I came here for the sturgeons on the Black Sea coast. I chose sturgeons because they're just amazing, really. Evolutionarily, they haven't changed since the Triassic period. It means they're prehistoric and just brilliant. And they're devoid of natural predators from like the first 2 months after they grow these amazing spiny, bony things on their back. But unfortunately, sort of a really slow respawn rate once every 2 years and the late reaching of sexual maturity from like 4 to 9 years old means that there's a lot of time for sort of them to be caught in the Caspian Sea by the Georgians or the Turks. Sturgeon is globally the most threatened species of fish, with all species being either endangered or critically endangered. And they're being wiped out at a rate of over 50% a generation. It's ridiculous. They're only really found in three areas, three different rivers, the Danube, the Garonne, and the Rioni River. And the Rioni River has some of the last breeding populations of six critically endangered species of sturgeon. The reason they're going extinct, I mean, the three reasons are pretty obvious: habitat disruption, poaching, and pollution. The biggest threat to the sturgeon is actually habitat destruction, and this comes in the form of hydropower projects, usually seen as great things for energy and water security, but can have devastating effects on the wildlife that inhabit the waters and streams around them. Already in the Rioni River, the habitat from sturgeons is reduced to 16% of what it once was. The second is also poaching. Sturgeons are supposed to be protected under the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species. You'll sort of know it as CITES. But unfortunately, I saw sturgeon for sale in the market in Poti, so obviously this isn't the case. The drive towards the destruction of this endangered species came to the attention of the good guys, WWF and Fauna and Flora International, around 2 years ago. I was fortunate enough to meet up with both of these organisations. First was WWF, and project assistant Nino kindly gave me a great introduction to everything that they're doing. WWF are mainly focusing on sort of the protected areas and the national parks, looking at protecting two specific areas, one on the mouth of the estuary where they're most easily caught, and second up in the breeding grounds up in Samtrader. Flora and Fauna International have got their sort of two different projects going on. They're in charge of the monitoring teams, which hope to sort of protect everything in the way that it's suggested that it should be on paper, and also the research side of things. And this is when I met up with the great researcher Tamari, who's out there on her own every day doing research and trying to find out what is actually out there. Tamari is everything I love about conservationists: a lone wolf battling against the odds, but spending every day in the water trying to find out really what is going on and to make a proper difference to this population. So shouts out to you, Tamari, and WWF and Flora and Fauna. And I really hope that your national parks come into fruition and all your plans and preparation can bring this species back from the brink of extinction, so yet again it can live for another 1 million years. Ramblings out.